so glad that you guys could come here and join us to come and worship our Lord and Savior Jesus and give praise to God for everything that he has done. And with that, we'll jump right into our announcements. So we have the Behold Your God study. You'll see it. It's the fourth one down. It's currently taking the place of the men's Bible study on Tuesday nights. That starts at 16:30 for food, 19:30 for the actual Bible study. And the POC for that is Chaplain Black, and that's here at the chapel. So if you're interested in that, please let Chaplain Black know, and he'll plug you right into that. Also, we have the women's Bible study, which is on Tuesdays at 18:30 as well. That's here in the chapel, too. And the POC for that is Imani Phillips. On Thursdays, we have the officers' Bible study, and that starts at 19:30. A meal is usually provided. And we're actually working through the book of Ephesians right now. So if you're interested in that, it usually rotates to different houses. Please see Jen or myself, and we'll definitely get you plugged in to that study. And then on Saturdays, we have the Knowing Scripture study. Breakfast is provided at 0900, and then the study starts at 0930. And that's another good study to learn how to interpret the Bible, and also it helps interpreting difficult passages. But with that, I'll ask if you will turn in with me to 1 Corinthians before we get started with our prayer time, before we worship. We'll be in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. And starting in verse 4. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for the prophecies, they will pass away. As for the tongues, they will cease. As for the knowledge, it will pass away. I was reading this passage this week, and it really made me think, because a lot of times we focus on, you know, spiritual gifts and stuff like that when we're doing our studies. But the most important thing is love. Jesus even said it. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, and soul. And love your neighbor as yourself. So my challenge to you is, what can we do to show the love of Christ to those around us that may not know? So as we come to prayer, to prepare our hearts and prepare our minds for worship, let's think of some ways this week we can show that love. Let us go to the Lord in prayer, take 15 seconds, and pray quietly at your pew, please. Father, we just come to you today to give you praise for allowing us to gather and come to worship you. We thank you for your great love, that you loved us so much that you sent your only Son to die on the cross for our sins so that we may have eternal life. Father, without you exemplifying this love, there would be no way for us to know how to love. We pray that we can imitate that through our daily lives, and that everything we do, we can glorify you, Father. God, as we come to worship, as we come to sing, as we come to hear the message that you've laid on Chaplain Black's heart, let us all be remembered. It's to glorify you. God, we just thank you so much for your forgiveness, for your grace, and your mercy. And we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Our call to worship comes out of Psalm. So, 111, verses 1 and 2. Praise the Lord. I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart in the company of the upright in the congregation. Great are the works of the Lord, studied by all who delight in them. Thank you. Let us stand and sing.
Blessed be your name in the land that is plentiful, streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name, we're found in the
right, you may be seated. Let's take our copy of God's Word and open up to our scripture reading, which is going to be from Psalm 32. Psalm 32. Song written by David and fits the theme with our sermon today. Similar to Psalm 51, if you're familiar with Psalm 51, it's a very famous psalm that deals with forgiveness, and so does this one. So here is what the Word of God says. Psalm 32. Blessed is the one whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. Blessed is the man against whom the Lord counts no iniquity, in whose spirit there is no deceit. When I kept silent, my bones wasted away through my groaning all day long. For day and night your hand was heavy upon me. My strength was dried up as by the heat of summer. I acknowledged my sin to you, and I did not cover my iniquity. I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord, and you forgave the iniquity of my sin. Therefore, let everyone who is godly offer prayer to you at a time when you may be found. Surely in the rush of great waters they shall not reach him. You are a hiding place for me. You preserve me from trouble. You surround me with shouts of deliverance. I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my eye upon you. Be not like a horse or a mule without understanding, which must be curbed with the bit and bridle, or it will not stay near you. Many are the sorrows of the wicked, but steadfast love surrounds the one who trusts in the Lord. Be glad in the Lord and rejoice, O righteous, and shout for joy, all you upright in heart. May God bless the reading of His Word. I'll ask the ushers to come forward, give us an opportunity to give. And after they're finished, I will give a prayer over this word and over the offering. Please join me in prayer. Father God, we thank you for the opportunity to give. We pray, Lord, knowing that you can take all that is given and you can make good things happen with it. Lord, to support the work here at the chapel and all the ministries and the outreach and the events, things designed to strengthen us spiritually here while we're at Insulik. So we ask your blessing on it. And Father, we also pray, thinking of the passage we read, Lord, help us to acknowledge our sin and not hide it, not to be silent, but instead to confess it to you, for you are ready to pardon. And that is a work of your grace, and we are so grateful for that. Strengthen us now, Lord, and give us energy as we continue to sing to you and worship you and look into your word. It's in Jesus' name we ask. Amen. Amen. Let us stand and continue to sing.